Hello and welcome to today's episode, LNG cargo tanks cool down procedures. This is part three. If you haven't seen part one and part two, please have a look prior watching this episode. So this one is outside on the trunk deck, which I will be attending the cargo tanks, which have spray pumps running, and the other ones which are having the cool down process on them. Plus, we will be checking out the cargo manifolds, port and starboard, to ensure that there is no LNG passing through the double shut valves and through the manual cool down valves on them. So now I'm at cargo tank number two on the helicopter winch area, passing by that and heading to cargo tank number one, where the spray pump is in operation. And now I will be going up the stairway that it's there and go to the liquid dome to inspect the parts. So now that we arrived here, you can see the cargo tank number one filling line. You will see the cargo tank pump discharge line, the cargo tank spray line, and the return valve. When you start the pump, that's what you need. And from the filling line here on the starboard is the discharge line, which is coming upwards, and forward of it is the discharge valve. And then we have the spray nozzle and the starboard side nozzle. Leaving the tank now and going from the forward part, you will see the valves which are there located. That's for the starboard and for the port side nozzle, which we don't need now because we are not cooling down the tank on this instance, since we have LNG inside and it's still cold. That will be cooled down later on at the end. And here on the left, this is the master spray valve. Here on the right, which here it distributes the LNG on the spray line, and this is the spray line filter nozzles in case it gets clogged from any type of residues that can remain inside the LNG. Then you can remove them and clean them. While walking now astern, it's very important to remind you that during cool down operations, no hot work is to be performed on deck. We'll have to have all the crew advised about the operation, and we need to also inform the bridge to pay attention on the deck. So while going to the aft now, we're passing by here and reaching to cargo tank number two, which is the tank which is currently performing cooling down. You will see in a while that the spray line which is passing through here, you just saw that it was frozen. This is the liquid coming through to the master valve, and then it's going to forward, passing through the filters and going to the port side nozzles, which you will see the port side valve, it's frozen and means that the LNG is passing and is cooling down the tank. So just remember that the liquid dome has to be always without water inside, has to be dry, and this is the temperature sensor where we'll see the temperature of the LNG passing by. Now, something that you need to remember is that during the operation, we need to check that there is no LNG passing inside through the return valve or through the discharge valve of the spray pump. So we only see here that LNG is passing through this port side railing piping, and everything is good here. The reason that we need to check on this is that because in case of leakage, the entry of LNG inside the tank, if it's a warm tank, it may damage the tank, and as a result you will not be able to perform cool down, and of course you will not be able afterwards to load the cargo. This valve here is something important that I will mention in a future episode, but for now I will not say anything. Whoever knows about it, you can keep it or you can leave a comment. Apologize for my glove being in the screen up there. is the safety relief valve. This is for the forward part of the spray line. And this is the isolation valve, the forward isolation valve, which isolates the spray line on the forward part. So now we'll be walking to the port side manifold in order to check that on the double shuts we don't see any sign of LNG, we don't see any signs of frost, and we also have a look on the liquid manifold's port side to see that we don't have anything there too. As I'm walking to the aft, I'm just checking on the upper parts to see that everything is as it is, no signs of frost. Because if we had signs of frost, then it means that LNG is passing by. So this is the double shut of number 4. And now I'm going to transfer to the starboard side, where I will have a look also the same thing there. Because in case you have a small list, this can result that the LNG is passing on the starboard side or the port side. So having a look also here for any possible leakage on the double shut valves. As I see here, I've pointed out on the with the arrows what is what, and down there looking on the liquid manifolds of 1, 2, 3, and 4, that they still remain as they are. Look at that cage. That cage is dedicated for transferring of personnel. This is the cargo tank number 3 vapor dome. You may see it's protected with a water spray system, which is located on the aft, and you can see it has 2 isolation valves which we never close. We always keep them open. And now we're going to move to the stern towards cargo tank number 3. As I said, this operation that we are doing is calling down of cargo tanks 2 and cargo tanks number 4. And this is done by isolating the valve. Again, this is the aft isolating valve, and on the stern here is a safety relief valve, again from the aft part of the spray line. Oh, apologize. This is not that. This is the valve from the subcooler line. So here is the master valve from the cargo tank number 3 for the spray line. And right here is the filters which exist in each tank, and they are there in case of any fracture, any item which will get stuck, it will go there. So it's very simple. You need to purge it with nitrogen and remove the filter in order to clean it. As I mentioned, is the return of the LNG to the subcooler. It's the LNG return line to the subcooler, which I'm going to show you like this. And this is a subcooler room. This is a vessel which is equipped with a subcooler system. And now I'm walking back to the cargo tank number 3 in order to see again the master valve, which is here on the port side. And you may see the special valve again, which is for a purpose that in case we need it of an emergency, we will use it. So moving astern, since I said we're not calling down cargo tank number 3, we are going now to follow the spray line, and we will come across with the distribution that can take place, meaning that the aft can be can supply LNG to the forcing vaporizer and to the LNG vaporizer if you need it, but this is not required during this operation. So now as we're going to move to the stern, I will just show you these valves. This is a valve which is opened in case you require to supply LNG inside the subcooler room. And as we're moving, we're passing the inlet gas line, and this is the vapor dome of number 4 cargo tank, which you can see it has signs of frost because now we've started cooling down. And what is happening is that the low duty compressors are sucking the vapors, are extracting the vapors, so it's becoming cold and cold since we are also performing a cool down operation of the tanks. And right here, is liquid dome number 4. You may see also the dry powder fixed system cabinet here, which is, as I remember, number 7. And if you haven't watched my episode in regards to the dry powder system, this is a good episode. You may have a look in regards to this fire protecting system on deck. So now I'm arriving actually on the liquid dome of cargo tank number 4, checking out also the lines here. You may see there's also a subcooler supply valve there, and there is the master valve for the spray line. Again, the checks are made here, checking out that we don't have any leakage. Remember always to have the plugs placed on the liquid dome drip trays. Of course, you always have your portable gas detector with you, keeping an eye that nothing is leaking,
or you press the ESD button,
or you report the issue in the CCR, because it can be a controllable leakage, meaning a small leakage, minor leakage, where you can put a rag with water and you can stop the leakage. So moving ahead from the liquid dome of cargo tank number 4, remember at all times to keep a safe distance during this operation from a possible leakage, and as I said, you may raise the ESD if required. So this here is the subcooler lower filling valve. So we're not using it currently because the subcooler is not in operation, and that's it. Last check on the liquid dome to ensure that there is no leakage, since this is a warm tank, and checking that there is no leakage to the bottom of the tank. So guys, thank you for watching today's episode. As you may see, it's not an easy task from the CCR. We go outside also to check that everything is working okay and everything is correctly lined up. This is done during the startup of the operation. So thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and stay safe to all of you sailing out there. Cheerio. Bye-bye.